Assalamualaikum. Hello everyone. Do you ever think about how your daily activities endanger the environment? Since the start of the COVID-19, most of us have found ourselves glued to the World Wide Web, either for work, for school, for socializing, or for entertainment. Have you ever wondered how your time on the internet is increasing your carbon footprint? Wait, what exactly is a carbon footprint anyways? Carbon footprint refers to man-made greenhouse gas emission that consists of carbon dioxide, methane, nitrous oxide, sulfur hexafluoride, and fluorocarbons. Too much of greenhouse gas emission increases the Earth's temperature in the atmosphere, directly causing climate change that lead to extreme droughts, disruption in water resources, and rising sea levels. Global greenhouse gas emissions come from various economic sectors. Electricity and heat production accounts for the main source of human greenhouse gas emissions.
You might be thinking, how am I increasing carbon emissions just by surfing the internet? The fact is that all my space account that you forgot to delete, the 5,000 emails left unread in your inbox, and a simple Google search you use to check the news of your favorite idols all have their own carbon footprints. How can something intangible and formless like the internet become a significant cause of global warming? The internet's carbon footprint can be divided into two. First, emissions from the manufacturing, shipping, and the use of internet devices, and second, emissions from powering and cooling data centers. Data centers are essentially what makes up the internet. These centers are connected by networks and host a massive number of data servers that allow you to access online content stored anywhere in the web at high speeds. Data centers are distributed across the globe and emit the second highest amount of greenhouse gases in the ICT industry. The electricity needed to run and maintain data centers worldwide translates into large carbon footprints, since the electricity used is sourced mainly from burning coal. Globally, data centers are estimated to consume around 1.1 to 1.5% of global electricity consumption, and these figures are expected to rise exponentially in the coming years due to increased internet usage worldwide and growth in data centers. The fact is, everything we do on internet directly contributes to climate change. Even this video that you are watching now.
So you might be wondering, Omo, otoke? How can I reduce my internet carbon footprint? I can't quit using it completely, can I? The solution is to practice the three R's, which are reduce, reuse, and recycle on the internet. Here are the things that you can do.
First, you can start by deleting irrelevant pictures, messages, and apps on your devices.
Second, be conservative in your emails. This means no more short thank you replies, clearing your email spams, avoiding CC when emailing, and unsubscribing to unnecessary newsletters. Remember, the more data stored, the more energy will be used, which equals more carbon footprint.
Third, swap email attachments to links instead, since email with an attachment is much heavier. For example, a photo attachment contributes to 50 grams of carbon dioxide, while regular email is only 0.3 grams of carbon dioxide. If the difference of 49.7 grams seems little to you, try to multiply it to the approximately 4.1 billion internet users worldwide. That will be 203.77 billion grams. This is equivalent to the total global carbon footprint of the aviation industry that projected to increase by 2-fold by 2025.
Fourth, cut back on your Google searches and YouTube binging. Try making your Google searches as accurate as possible and limit the amount of YouTube videos you watch in a day. Cutting back on unnecessary Google searches can save up to 1 billion grams of carbon dioxide emission, and while reducing YouTube usage can save 4 times more than that.
Fifth, switch off and unplug unused devices to save energy. Electricity current is still running and will be wasted even when your device is unused. If you are resting for a short duration, sleeping mode is an alternative that uses less energy.
6. Reuse your devices by handling down or donating old ones to others when purchasing new devices is absolutely necessary. This is specifically true for smartphones, who have had the most dominant carbon footprint in this new age of technology.
Lastly, if the devices were damaged beyond repair, recycling is the best option to ensure that its material can efficiently be renewed with another lifetime.
Overall, the amount of carbon footprint that can be saved may seem little individually, but if we all collectively implement these simple suggestions, significant and prevalent environmental changes may be seen. Therefore, it is really important to let everyone know about this. So please, spread awareness by sharing this with others. Remember, giving the link itself is enough instead of emailing it as an attachment.